It's another weekend and it's time to go through our weekend action of football. My name is Godfred. Let's start in Spain, where a lot of big things have been happening, especially at the Mestalla, home of Valencia Football Club. Now, early in the week, the announcement was made that Nuno Espirito Santo, their coach, had departed and had been replaced by his assistant, Phil Neville. Then, the big news. Big brother of Phil Neville, Gary Neville, was confirmed as the coach of the team till the end of the season. So it's an English partnership to the end of the season. But no bigger test for brother Phil, who will be in charge. Gary will not be in charge this weekend. Phil will be in charge when league leaders Barcelona visit the Mestalla for a league game. Now, the problem for Valencia this season has not been that they are playing badly. They are playing really well, just that they are not scoring enough goals. And Alvaro Negredo will be one player who is very, very happy that there's a new man in charge, especially for the complaints that he was making, that he felt the team was not creating enough chances for him to score. Hopefully, that is a problem that will not come to the fore against Barcelona, because one rarely gets chances against Lucho Enrique's team. Now, they are playing with Lionel Messi, they are playing with Neymar, they are playing with Luis Suarez. Two of those three have been nominated for the Ballon d'Or, and one of them will definitely win. We know, you know who is going to win. How the game will go? I think that Barcelona, far too strong, too much quality for a dispirited Valencia side that is trying to rebuild itself. A comfortable victory for Barcelona. Away from Spain, Germany. Things not too interesting in Germany at the moment, primarily because Bayern Munich seem to have run away from the league. But this weekend, though, interesting fixture. Borussia Dortmund will be traveling to Wolfsburg, who are in third place. So it's third welcoming second. Now, Thomas Tuchel's team, Dortmund, had been in a bit of trouble in recent weeks, but they got their act back together, courtesy of Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. Now, they'll be visiting Bas Dost and his friends at Wolfsburg, who also have a pretty decent attacking record. I favour the home team in this one. I think that Borussia Dortmund are not playing too well away at the moment, and Wolfsburg will get a very, very clean win over Dortmund in this game. Final stop is in England and the Premier League, and significant games there, but the one I want to start with is Chelsea in 14th position. Yes, Chelsea are climbing up the table, 16th, 15th, now 14th. Now, they drew goalless with London rivals Tottenham Hotspurs last week, but not without some controversy. Spanish striker Diego Costa threw his bib. Yes, he dared to throw his bib at Jose Mourinho. I have a feeling he's going to start on the bench in this game. Eden Hazard going to start up front, either with Loic Remy or by himself. Now, Bournemouth will also be feeling pretty comfortable after they drew 3-3 with Everton. Yes, that looks like a result they should not be happy with. But when you are down and out like Bournemouth were, that result tends to give you confidence. And Jose Mourinho's squad will be licking their chops at the prospect of this visit. I expect a pretty comfortable victory for Jose Mourinho's squad as they continue their gradual ascent up the league table. Now, I'll follow that with Manchester United, who will be welcoming West Ham United. It's become pretty tedious predicting Manchester United games these days. It will be easy to say they will draw games because that is what they do. They've drawn a lot of games in the past 2 months. Fans are not too happy with the way Louis van Gaal's squad is playing, and they could have been top of the league if they are just taking a few of their chances. Now, West Ham under Slaven Bilic play really, really good football. Now, Lanzini and Zarate, the two Argentines, seem to be getting things on for the Hammers, and I think that they will fancy their chances against a very possession biased Manchester United. But at home, I expect Manchester United to get the result. We know they won't score too many, they won't concede too many as well. Narrow victory for Manchester United over Slaven Bilic's West Ham United. Final game in the Premier League we'll be looking at involves Swansea. Now, they started on a high, but things are going pretty badly for Andre Ayew and Gary Monk at the moment. They are lying 15th and they'll be playing Leicester City, who are in second with Jamie Vardy up front. But the Liberty Stadium, I expect Gary Monk's squad to be the favourite. And I expect Andre Ayew, newly nominated for another Player of the Month award, to get another goal, rise up the prize and help Swansea out of the relegation zone. Easy victory for Swansea for me is my prediction. My name is Godfred, and for those of you who like to make a quick bet, superbets.com.gh is your website.